Thank you for joining this video about consistency large language models, or CLLMs in short. CLLMs were introduced in a recent research paper that goes by the same name. As we all know, top LLMs such as GPT-4, Llama 3 and more are pushing the limits of AI to remarkable advancements. However, when we feed the LLM with a prompt, it only generates a single token at a time. In order to generate the second token in the response, another pass of the LLM is needed, now both with the prompt and the generated token. Then we have two generated tokens. In order to generate another token in the response, we need to do this again, now providing the LLM both with a prompt and the two generated tokens. Obviously, this behavior is causing latency when using LLMs, and so a common research domain is to improve LLM inference latency. The paper we explain in this video shows a method to generate multiple tokens in one LLM pass, rather than token by token, and the researchers show an improvement of 2.4 to 3.4 times in generation speed, while preserving the quality. The method of CLLMs is based on an existing method which is called Jacobi decoding. With this method, instead of generating a single token at a time, we generate a sequence of tokens on one pass. We feed the LLM both with the prompt and the response, which is random at first, and we iteratively fix the response sequence. The path between the random starting point and the final response is called the Jacobi trajectory. To explain it, we use the following figure from the paper. At the bottom, we can see the prompt in blue and the initial random response sequence in gray, where each token is marked with a red X, since it is a wrong prediction at this stage. The circle on the right represents the starting point of the Jacobi trajectory. In each step, we feed the prompt and the current response sequence into the LLM, and fix every token in the response sequence if needed. It is important to mention that this is done in a single LLM pass, since we can update each token by masking out future tokens for each token that we update. After each iteration, we have more correct tokens in the response sequence than before, and another point is added to the Jacobi trajectory. After enough iterations of this, we converge into a valid response, which is the final point in the Jacobi trajectory. However, in practice, this approach does not significantly improve the latency, and there are two reasons for that. One is that in each iteration, each LLM pass is slower, since we process also the response sequence tokens in each iteration. Second is that the LLM is usually able to fix only one token from the response sequence, or a bit more on average. Stay tuned until the end to understand how this method is dramatically improved with CLLMs. Before moving on, if you are getting value from this content, then please consider subscribing to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. We also send 1-minute read summaries by mail about the papers we review here. You may find the link to join in the description of this video. The method of consistency large language models has a very strong analogy from the computer vision domain, which is improving the performance of diffusion models using consistency models. Diffusion model is the backbone architecture behind the top text-to-image generation models. Diffusion models get a prompt as an input, such as a cat is sitting on a laptop, and the model learns to gradually remove noise from an image in order to generate a clear image, based on the prompts. The model starts with a random noise image, like we have here on the left, and in each step it removes some of the noise. The noise removal is conditioned on the input prompt, so we'll end with an image that matches the prompt. The three dots imply that we skip steps in this example. Finally, we get this nice clear image of a cat, which we take as the final output of the diffusion model for the provided prompt. The noise removal process can take between tens to thousands of steps, so it comes with a latency drawback. To avoid the latency drawbacks, consistency models were invented. Consistency models reduce the number of iterations required to remove the noise from an image. So, what are consistency models? Consistency models are similar to diffusion models in the sense that they also get a prompt and learn to remove the noise from an image. So, here for example, we have the diffusion path of a cat image, same as before. However, consistency models learn to map between any image on the same denoising path to the clear image. So, we call them consistency models because the models learn to be consistent for producing the same clear image for any point on the same path. With this approach, a trained consistency model can jump directly to a clear image from a noisy image. In practice, few iterations of noise removal are needed here as well, but just a few, much less than with diffusion models. With this in mind, let's now understand how consistency LLMs improve the performance of LLMs. The first step is to create a dataset of Jacobi trajectories. We do that by taking a pre-trained LLM and run Jacobi decoding as we've seen earlier over as much prompts as we want. Now that we have such a dataset, we look at a Jacobi trajectory for example. And similar to consistency models for diffusion models, here as well we train the model to yield the final point in the Jacobi trajectory from each of the intermediate points. Which model do we train? The same LLM that we've used to create the Jacobi trajectories dataset. Now if we go back to the Jacobi decoding figure, we still run a Jacobi decoding process, but we replace the regular LLM with a CLLM, which was trained over Jacobi trajectories, and this way significantly speed up the decoding process. In the following figure from the paper, we see an example for how such a decoding may look like for a standard LLM and a consistency LLM, where blue tokens are correct and red ones are wrong. On the left, we see a Jacobi trajectory for a standard LLM, showing 14 steps until all tokens are correct. And on the right we see a Jacobi trajectory for a consistency LLM, which only has 6 steps. Let's now also take a look at a quantitative comparison. In the following table from the paper we see a comparison over the MET dataset GSM 8K. In the first row we have a standard LLM we compared to. By just using Jacobi with standard LLM we see there is no significant speedup. We did not talk about look ahead in this video, but this is another improvement that is using Jacobi decoding. In this case, it achieves a speedup of 1.7. When looking at the CLLM results, we see it is 3 times faster, and we pay a bit in performance, which is 56.4 comparing to 59.1 before. Medusa is a different method to predict multiple tokens at once, which we see performs worse in this case, and also that the model size is larger. Speculative decoding achieves identical performance with a speedup of 1.7, but here as well the model architecture is not identical to the original LLM as with CLLM. Another table from the paper shows the comparison on empty bench, where here we see that Jacobi with CLLM achieves 2.4 speedup with just a slight decrease in performance. Medusa achieves a bit better speedup in this case, but again we pay for a larger model size with Medusa. Speculative decoding again achieves an identical performance, but with a lower speedup. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more reviews of AI papers.